You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment. Very good,
The AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California. Presented by Maria Menounos and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is AfterBuzz TV's Love & Hip Hop After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's Love & Hip Hop After Show.
I'm a boss ass bitch, 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 bitch. I'm a boss ass bitch, 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 bitch.
Hey, what up, AfterBuzz? Your boy DJ Jesse here at the AfterBuzz TV studios for the Love & Hip Hop New York After Show. Episode 7, Mess All Over the World. I mean, it's a mess in New York after watching this damn episode.
Right.
Ooh, I'm joined in studio by the lovely Nicolette Gaona.
Hey, y'all.
Unfortunately, Cornelia Stradwick could not be here because she being thirsty over at the Magna Carta tour.
Oh,
I'm just kidding. Really, I ain't even mad at her.
I ain't mad either.
But we have a new host who will be joining us every week, the lovely Julie Ofcharsky.
Hello.
Yay! She stopped me. She was like, Jesse, I need to read some bitches for life, and I love loving hip hop.
It's true. I'm very excited to be here, so thank you for having me.
Well, let's open the library. Let's start out with these boring-ass bitches, Tahiri and her sister. Tahiri is now having second thoughts about selling hoes to open a church. All right. Jiminy Cricket done took a visit over to Tahiri's house with a conscience and was like, bitch, you cannot sell hoes to open up a damn church.
Right. Mm. And my thing is, the only reason Tahiri has her sister on the show is because Joe is not in the picture anymore, so she needs a reason to be on the show, and so this is what it is. And I think it's horrible. Sorry.
I'm like, her sister is just doing the most.
I'm just like, her sister just don't even know how to handle on being on TV, first of all.
Her sister cries every 5 fucking seconds.
And they obviously have some tea that they need to figure out.
Not on the show.
Yeah, exactly. Not on the camera.
Exactly.
So sorry to hear. You have no storyline anymore, and this needs to go.
Her sister is crying. She feels disappointed. Like, Tahiri was all about it at first, and then now she's changing her mind. This has happened my whole life. I'm 30 years old, and I just feel like I'm being turned down. Girl, then you need to figure out some things about your damn self.
Okay. How are you on TV for 2 episodes of a damn show and you cry both episodes? Like, this is your big shot. First of all, get your fucking hair done. Second of all, take a fucking Valium. Tone it down several notches because we can't. I can't.
You are the long-lost sister that needs to be lost again.
And Tahiri's just sitting there. When she walked out the room, it looked like Tahiri was like, oh, fuck, why did I even do this?
Yeah.
This is why we haven't talked
so
for 5
stressful.
Years. This is why we fucking haven't talked for 5 years. Forgot about it. She's like, where the fuck is Joe? At this point.
No, yeah, he wasn't even in this episode.
Mm. Joe ain't even, he don't even care no more. Joe is so over it, I feel like.
Well, I think he's back with, what's her name? Damn.
Kaylin.
Chipmunk.
Kaylin.
Yeah.
Kaylin Garcia.
Ooh. Mm-hmm.
I love that you know their last names.
Clock the tea, honey.
Let's clock it on Saigon. He brings his boo, Erica Jean, into the studio.
Apologizes.
First
good
I'm
for
like,
you.
Why are you in a studio? What music do you make in 2019?
My whole thing with them is, it's like, he came to her and he's like, oh, well, I just feel like we should take him to a specialist and all this stuff, and was super, like, sweet and nice about it. Why couldn't you have been like that at the fucking restaurant? Because you attacked the bitch at the damn restaurant and threw her a Louis Vuitton bag.
You gave my son autism. Like it's
what?
Not contagious.
Like, that is not how it works. And then she's like, well, I appreciate that. I accept your apology. Like, bitch.
When do we start accepting mediocrity? Like, why? Like, why are we accepting, oh, you know what? I'm not mad at him. I'm not mad at him anymore. He apologized. Why aren't you mad at him?
Yeah.
What are you laughing at?
I'm sorry. But,
it smells like trash.
Oh. All right, we have our dog in here, and he's.
And this is why.
I'm trying not to look at you. I'm like, girl.
Girl, I mean, that's something you cannot deny.
I'm sorry, Erica Mena. Could you just close it? She's going to join us in a second.
I'm like trying not to look at her. I'm like, oh my Lord.
All right. So, you know, she says, Saigon apologized. He says wrong. No one should talk to the mother of his child. And, guys, don't do that. I just walked over here now.
Sorry. It's bad.
Damn.
It's bad.
Sorry.
Yeah.
All right. So, anyways, she says that, you know, that's really big of him. And she accepts that they're going to go get their son tested. Mm-hmm. So then they go get their son tested.
And then they don't even talk about the son.
Yeah. And I'm like, they go in there, and the psychologist is looking at them like they're scared as fuck. Like, she's scared as fuck. She's like, hi, welcome for coming. So we did the test, and basically there's nothing wrong with your son, but is there something going on with the two of you that you guys want to talk about? Like,
awkward, yeah.
Awkward moment 101.
I liked that she was super condescending towards both of them, though. Like, she was super like, well, sometimes adults need help communicating, too.
So if,
like,
you ever need help figuring those words out, you can come talk to me. She was like, bitch, can we get them the hell out?
Yeah, I feel like she's just like, I mean, this is something that normal people should just already know. Like, you guys really have these issues?
And then Erica swears in front of her son.
Yeah, like, you don't give a fuck about me. Not, you don't care about me. You don't give a fuck. And your son is sitting on your lap. It's clear as day. Like,
I can't. Trash. Trash. Pure trash.
Alrighty. Well, I think the psychologist was looking at her more like, are y'all autistic? Like,
right. Do you need help with this child? Dirt around here.
For real.
All right, let's move to K Michelle. K Michelle now has black hair this week. Right. She sits down with management, and basically she wants management to help her hire better workers.
She wants to be like Beyonce, honey. That's never gonna happen. Mm. Okay, I love you. I love your music, but that's never happening. Okay.
She's
go next.
says her house has demons, whatever that means. Okay. And then she is trying to bring her woo-ha back, talking about, will management find her someone to handle that?
You should have kept the woo-ha in ATL because it's not coming to New York. Okay, so leave that behind. We don't care about your woo-ha. We obviously have seen your woo-ha.
Well, she says that the picture that's been going around of her camel toe, it was photoshopped.
Like I said to you earlier, her crotch was hungry. It was clearly eating her fucking pants.
And don't be mad.
Okay, Michelle, where is the dick? Where is the dick? Ripping through her nylon. Like.
For real. But also, the thing that gets me about K. Michelle is that all she does is bitch and complain about how she can't get a man. But then if you notice, every time a man even approaches her, the bitch is like, get the fuck away from me, like, super defensive. Like, mm-hmm. She hates men. Like, she's rude to every man. She's always getting in fights with men. Every time a man talks to her, it's a problem.
I mean, she has been through it, okay? She really
I get it, but
it,
bitch,
but
don't be complaining about your fucking woo-ha.
You ain't showing no love.
Exactly.
Because I feel like K. Michelle's the type of dude that just likes the wrong dudes. Like,
she likes the thugs.
She wants her, like Beyonce Soldier, like that video.
Yeah, she was really. Like, I mean, and I ain't mad at her for that.
Boys up top.
Okay, I ain't even mad at that. But you got to know how to handle them. You can't be like all like. I mean, you can put them in check, but you also got to show them a lot of love first. Show them love, real men, then put them in check. Then you're good.
I'm like, I don't know if your house has demons or your vagina has demons.
Her it's vagina needs to be exercised because it is possessed, honey. Let me get some sage for your coochie.
So then she sits with her best friend, Tracy, and her homegirl comes talking about, are you pregnant? Bitch, you know she ain't pregnant. You know you've been with her for how long?
Paris, you need to sit your ass down.
She stay talking about she don't get no dick. What is she doing?
Like,
that she pregnant?
First of all, Paris, you over here acting like her best friend. Y'all acting like y'all sisters. Why the hell would you really question if she was pregnant? That really bothered me. Because
K. Michelle wanted her to do that.
Exactly. She could make a big scene about it.
That's really dumb.
First of all, you're crying over media takeout. Like, out of all of them. Now, if it was like the New York Times is saying K. Michelle's pregnant.
E-News. Girl, this is media takeout. This is probably all these little blogs that don't matter.
I mean, you know what? Even Nicole Bitchy, I wouldn't even mind, or Bossip, but
Media takeout. And furthermore, like, it's not even a believable fucking rumor. All you do is complain about how you're not getting any dick. So who was reading that article
you know
and
what?
Thinking
they
you're pregnant?
They probably saw the camel toe thing and they're like, maybe the baby reaching and he grabbing. Like,
But for real, like, nobody has believed that rumor. And then you're going to cry about it. Girl, it's not that serious. You should be happy people are even talking about you, that you're on the radar.
I feel like this is a negative thing for K. Michelle to be on the show, because actually this is the second or third thing that I haven't liked about her. The first being her complaining, oh, my assistant, like, it was raining and the car wasn't right there when I got there.
Yeah.
And all these fans were taking pictures of me and being like, oh, K. Michelle don't got a car. Like, girl.
You need to calm down.
But I mean, really, how many fans? Like, I know, I'm not bashing K. Michelle. I'm not saying K. Michelle don't have fans. But I'm just saying, like,
I mean, you can't really miss her. You know,
she is not to that level, though, where she's getting swarmed by people in the fucking streets.
Walking around being like, oh my God, that's K. Michelle. Like, I'm sure there are a few, you know what I mean?
I really honestly feel like there is, though. Really? I'm sure she has, yeah, I mean, especially, like, in the South and really, like, in that vicinity. If she came over here, no, not as much. But, like, on that end, I feel like she does have a lot of fans.
New York?
I do feel like that, honestly, because, I mean, especially the people who, like, have really promoted their music and stuff like that. I mean, I'm a big fan of her. You know what I'm saying? I feel like there really are a lot of girls who really look up to her. She just shouldn't be so divish, honestly. Because her music, I'm sorry, it rocks. Like,
her music, I am a fan of her music.
She'd be really letting all the women, like, just, you know, have it. Like,
I'm just not a fan of her crying. I'm over it.
Yeah, well, no, I mean, definitely. She definitely, I don't feel like she deserves to be a diva. That's what I don't feel like she deserves.
Yeah, she's not at that level.
I do feel like she does deserve a really great fan base, because
but you know
she does
what?
Have really great music.
If I was her, I'd feel like a diva too if I was on the show with someone of the likes of Erica Mena, who walks in with Rich and he says, hey, plate thrower. And she said, I would have threw his bitch if she didn't run so fast. Rewind, because if we rewound it, Amina didn't move from the table.
Yeah. Amina didn't know what to do.
Right.
She was just like, I'm so confused.
Amina's probably sitting there like, wait, did he fuck her too? What's going on?
Fucking Amina.
Amina? Oh my God.
Amina. I can't. So
Mrs. Panky, you hot damn mess.
Peter talks to her and, you know, he says, Rich talks about Peter and says, you know, Erica, you need to calm down. You're getting too crazy. Like, bitch, you can't be throwing plates. And Erica's like, he's a joke. And she said, basically, you know, why are you bringing him into this? I signed the contract because I wanted to be closer to you. If you asked me if I wanted the song, the contract, I would have picked you over everything.
Basically, she's trying to not make herself look crazy. She's trying to spin it around and just make it about, like, them. And
I think she looks extra crazy. Because, like, bitch, you're in this fake lesbian relationship with your goddamn cousin.
It is Chipotle. So fake.
Like, y'all are definitely related.
For real. Like, you're in a fake lesbian. You're paying your fucking cousin to be in a fake relationship with you on
TV.
To
make out with her.
And you're in a fake relationship with fucking Rich.
I love you, Cyn. I love you, too.
After that dick pics got released of him, like...
He just looks like a mushroom.
That
to
beer
me.
Can.
Like, you're a mushroom.
No.
Go back on Mario, brother.
Anyone whose last name or namesake is Dollars just needs to go somewhere. Like, it's not happening. Go away.
So then Yandy sits down with Rich, and she apologizes for being stressed over Mendeecees. And then we find out that Mendeecees says he might have a good chance of getting out early.
Sure. Right.
All right. Over that one. Then Rich goes and sits down with Peter, and Rich is trying to, like, defend Peter. And Peter basically says, you need to choose royalty or ratchetness.
First of all, are you talking about yourself?
Oh, no.
Are you the ratchet? Are you the ratchet?
What are you talking about?
Because it should be ratchet or ratchet. Do you want this ratchet or do you want this ratchet?
Which
do you want
kind
the girl
of ratchet?
And I'm sure you want the pussy ratchet instead of the dick ratchet, because dick ratchet is not going to help you out in no way.
For real.
Or, I wonder, sorry. I think, though, he wasn't referring to himself. I think he was referring to his Amina as being royalty. And I'm like, well, where is
her
king?
Oh, no, honey.
You need
really,
to be married to a
no,
king.
No, that is not. He was all about himself. He was not thinking
no,
about
no, I think
no
he was
bitch.
Talking about himself.
He was definitely
really?
Talking about himself.
Which
it
is
Peter Guns
goddamn
here, who does not
ass.
Give a fuck about no woman but himself and what he wants.
He's the definition
he's really
of ratchet.
Thinking, of that himself is royalty, and he is not royalty. He is far from royalty. He is
Peter Pan. This is a man that has never grown up. He ain't
for real.
Peter Guns, he is Peter Pan.
For Peter real. Pan. He's like a 13-year-old.
Neverland. The land that you live, that couch, he'd be laying on Tara's couch just pretending that they're in a happy relationship. He'd be like...
I don't know what really be going through his head. Like, honestly, this whole situation really pisses me off. It just really pisses me off. Like... The fact that he's getting away with this shit is pissing me off. Like, these girls are really that low.
They're but
really
that's that the low. Whole thing that gets me is like the two. You'll see the two of them, and it's the same thing that happened on Love and Hip Hop Atlanta with fucking Jocelyn and Mimi. The two of them every week is like, I am done with this. I am done with that. I'm not standing for this. At but least. Then you continue fucking putting up with it. Tara, it took 2 seconds for Peter to get in your fucking pants after he told you like an hour before that he was fucking married. Right. You hot damn mess.
At least Mimi on the other season was like going out. She found a new dude. Right. You know what I'm saying? At least she putting herself out there to do other things. These two
but
are
it took
really,
a while,
fighting, they're really fighting over Peter Pan.
For real.
And who then will Tara, never have a normal life.
And then Tara shows up to the goddamn basketball court with her fugly ass haircut.
Rule 21 jeans.
Awful,
sorry, girl. And a Forever 21 top.
God awful
with
top.
A chili bowl haircut. Chili
girl,
bowl haircut. Girl,
what
if you're
you
trying
doing?
To stunt on a man, you not cut your hair in a chili bowl.
For
with
real.
With those bangs.
I cannot.
Like, she was really
Peter.
Trying. Oh my gosh, she really was trying. Oh,
I can't.
Let's leave Tara.
But Amina be trying too. They just really both be trying. Honestly though, like, I just can't. They just really. Like, Tara needs to have been left him. Like, Amina, I really just don't even care about because she's just a hot mess and really, like, trying to play wife. And it's like, girl, you were never going to see
slow.
His kids, first of all.
Wait, let's get into that
okay.
in a second. I'm not
I
there
really
yet. So, Peter calls Erica nasty, evil, disgusting. I'm like, sir, do you need a mirror?
Right. Because you talk
You know what?
Yourself.
We'll let you just say what you want to say, and then you're gonna. He's sitting here now watching all these episodes, like... I can imagine, like, Corey Guns must be sitting at home, like...
Isn't Corey Guns in jail? Isn't that his son?
Oh, because he was facing that charge. I don't know if he's actually in it yet. But...
Yeah.
All right, so before that, then we should go over to a photo shoot of Erica in Panama with Cyn.
Oh, my God.
Erica was humbled spiritually.
Holding Why a fucking refugee
like...
baby.
What, bitch, this is not Beyonce's Cuba trip. Who are you? Why are you holding the baby?
The She's baby's like, coming. The baby's probably looking at her like, get away from me.
Who the fuck? Like, I need to know who allowed Erica Mena to hold their child. Mm. Like, you need to be arrested for challenging.
She's a mother herself.
She
oh,
is.
I forgot.
Mm. Oh,
sorry,
good Lord Almighty.
I'm sorry. I really honestly feel bad for her child.
I would like to know what the situation is with the child because we've never seen the child. And I wonder if it's like her mom watches it or like is like,
it.
Yeah, like her mom
Jesse.
Is. The, you know
no, that's
I mean?
Really sad actually that she never talks about her son.
It's a son. Well, I mean, it's a good or a bad thing. And a bad thing. I mean, it's a good thing kind of.
No, she should protect her child.
Yeah, don't put your son on this show.
Girl.
Like, as cute as little B, Steven, or whatever Saigon's damn child's name is, he's adorable, but, like...
They're pointing him in a shitty position.
Like, he's gonna watch his back later and laugh, like, I was really sitting in the middle of this situation.
For real.
All 10 of Peter Pan's children are gonna be looking
oh
at this
God.
Show like, Dad, like...
They're
and who knows
father.
What other bitches he's out there having relationships
For
with.
For real. For real.
All right, so wait, we're back on the photo shoot. And again, why was she even home? I can't.
Right. Like, it brought us closer than ever. Like, you guys have just been dating for a month.
And your cousins, so there's that.
Like I said, I just can't wait till
so
she gets a herpes outbreak.
And, you know, like, I just.
They were just getting paid to fuck some Panamanians together.
Could you imagine if that was the whole thing that they were like escorts down in Panama? The cover was a photo shoot.
Shit, I'd pay to have sex with her girlfriend. She's hot as fuck.
Cyn, yeah, she's pretty. So then we go back. We're back in New York. Erica and Cyn are at Synergy. I don't know if this is like a bathhouse, a sex.
I don't know
like
what
a brothel,
that was,
like what.
They were just trying to have a moment.
They're playing in a bathtub, and I'm like, first of all, that's.
And Erica's face is melting off.
And she's
like,
looking really crazy. Like,
she looks crazy.
We find out that they're falling in love with each other, and then we get
like,
a vacuum kiss.
I just, like, really love you.
Falling
like,
in love with you.
Erica couldn't even talk. Like, she was like, trying to, like, because it was so staged, like, she was really trying to figure
that
out what
kiss.
She was going to say.
That
no,
kiss.
So fake.
Oh, my God. She, like, attacked her with her fucking tongue. They were, like, hitting each other's faces. I was like, this is the most forced thing I've ever seen in my life.
Like, if they were really loving each other, they would be all over each other.
Oh, 1,000%.
They didn't even
want to
touch each other. They're like, okay, this is the part where we kiss. Let's just get this over with real quick. All right.
I can't. I can't.
I don't know. I can't decide if it's real or fake or not.
Really?
Because I feel like...
It is not real. Bitch talked about Chipotle at every episode. The only thing they had in common.
She's trying to get a plug.
The only thing they had. A plug. Chipotle.
Food. Because we clearly see Erica's been eating it. I'm just kidding, that was wrong. All right. Oh, let's get into it. Amina and Peter. Amina meets Peter at a guitar shop. She's probably buying him his new guitar because the man can't afford him damn. So she's upset that Peter has been disappearing at night.
I'm surprised they didn't go to a park again. Sorry.
She didn't have another song.
Yeah.
Oh, she's what, like, the fuck was that?
I'm upset that you were disappearing. I'm upset that you left your ring at home.
My thing is like, why are you now being so tough on him to be, like, your husband?
And then being surprised that he wants to run away from your fucking ass when he told you from jump, oh, I love being with you because it's an escape from all the bullshit and Tara's nagged me. Like, and now, all of a sudden you get a ring on your finger, Tara. And you think that you can, like, lock this man down, like he needs to be sleeping with you every night. Honey, guess what? No, that's not how it works.
He said, you're fucking up a good thing. You're becoming Tara and you're chasing me off. My thing is, Peter, I mean, it's called basic mentality. That's not what she's doing. That's not what Tara's doing. You're acting like a fucking idiot. Mm-hmm. You're literally cheating. You're wrong, and you can't accept that you're wrong. You go and you apologize to these girls, and you say, you know, my fault. You know what I mean? Like, I take it back. Like, I love you, babe. But then you go and you stick your dick in the other bitch. Now, my thing is, and then you can't even be smart about it. But, ooh, we gonna get there. But my thing is with Peter, now Amina wants to see his kids. And he's talking about, yeah, I have to sleep over there because my kids are crying.
Oh, my God. That pissed me the fuck off. Like, do not use your kids as an excuse because, A, we have not even seen them. We damn sure haven't seen them crying for you. We did see you fucking Tara on the fucking couch. When you're telling Amina you're done with this bitch, get the fuck out of here.
And really is like, well, you can see so-and-so because the other one's going to snitch.
Oh, I know. I was like, dude.
Amina, as a woman, as a human being, you're allowing someone to
degrade you and control you.
Puppet you. You are fucking Pinocchio, bitch.
Yeah, and like, he's a huge piece of shit, but they are both making themselves look so dumb.
She will never have a music career after this.
Oh no, 1000% no.
Like, they're gonna be looking at her laughing. Like, she's just laughable. It's just laughing. It's like, do you really honestly think he's gonna be honest with you? Do you really think?
It's such a joke.
All right, maybe she did, though, and then we'll continue to the next scene, okay. Which it's like, now, bitch, after this time, I'm gonna need you to put the dick down. Step away from the penis. So we get a club, and Yandy's there with some man.
Mm. Yeah, honey. I'm sure he was an artist, honey.
Sure, right. You know, like
sure
she said.
Paints your pussy, honey.
She's looking for talent.
And he looks talented.
He looks very talented.
So then we got.
I would have looked for him too.
K. Michelle showed up. All right, interesting. And then all of a sudden, Peter and Amina show up. And Amina, in her one shot, says, "Peter wanted to take me out, so of course we bump into Yandy."
What a coincidence!
Y'all
could have
walked right by them and not even paid them.
No, they couldn't because they couldn't have paid the bill. That's why they went to, Peter wanted to take me out. With what paycheck?
And didn't you ask them for drinks? Like, oh yeah, we need drinks. Like,
oh,
Peter called up.
Lord.
I guarantee you, Peter called up the production company and was like, yo, you want to sing with me and Amina? They were like, all right, well, if you want the table, you got to share with Yandy and this because we're shooting tonight.
Right.
Bitch, he didn't take you on a date. Like, she's like, hey, my man took me on a date tonight. Like, girl, bye. Get your damn fucking life. So then she sits there and, like, bitch, he's broke. He wanted the free bottle service. So then she sits there. K. Michelle says, well, let's talk about the elephant in the room.
With her messy ass.
When's the last time you slept with Tara? Yandy says, never. Did he sleep with her 3 weeks ago?
No, she was like, you really going to ask a married man that basically...
He's not going to say that he slept with Tara 3 weeks ago. So basically, like, dancing around the topic, but putting it right in Amina's face.
Exactly.
Amina's like, what?
And it's like, what? Peter.
And she was just so, like, it flew right over her fucking head.
And then Peter's sitting there trying to justify shit, and he's talking about, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know what the girls want. Like, they just want, like, a sit down, and then, like, we're gonna do the timetable thing, and, like, you know, if that happens, then maybe we won't be together. I won't be with either girl, and that might be the best thing in my life. Amina, do you hear what is coming out of this man's fucking mouth at this point? Like, move on.
But then my whole thing, is then Peter gets, like, pissed. He's like, well, why are they bringing this shit up? They're not supposed to be bringing that shit up. What the fuck is their loyalty to you? You're fucking these two bitches. You're fucking over their friend, and they're supposed to be loyal to you and sit there and not say anything? Of course they're going to call your messy ass out. Get the fuck out of here. What was that? Oh, they shouldn't be saying anything. Please. Get a clue. Peter fucking guns.
Oh, okay, well, he's a joke, but you know what? I've rooted for Tara, but after this scene, Tara. Nah. So let me get Tara and Yandy. And Yandy tells Tara about the wedding bands and all that, and Tara's like, wedding bands? He don't wear them wedding bands around me? Ah, that's messed up, because 3 weeks ago, what'd she say? If whenever I want it, I've taken it. She said, I've already taken Plan B twice.
Girl.
On national television.
Girl.
On national television.
I fell the fuck out
first
when
of all,
she ever said that.
When she said that, I rewound to him with his naked little feet on the couch. When he was like, baby, come here. And then this bitch really climbed onto his lap, thinking that was sexy. You look at this broke-ass motherfucker laying on your broken
couch.
For
real. Doing you dirty.
Couldn't even afford the damn socks because he left all his clothes at the other house. So he's sitting there.
You know, I just really hope she just fucking with him and just fucking him because she just wants to get... I don't know. I just feel like she honestly fucking him because she's like, she just knows what the situation is.
I get that. Like, I get that that's what she's doing.
I don't think that's what she's doing.
Because she's so angry and she's been with him 15 years. And now she's just like, you know, I'm fucking.
I think she's trying. I think she's still slightly delusional. Like, I think after she watches this season, she might be like, okay. But I think in the moment of this all happening, she's delusional. And she's like, I'm going to try to keep my family together.
I get
that. Well, clearly, because that's why she stormed onto the basketball court.
Goddamn mess.
Why are you doing this? You sleeping with me and then you're doing this? Bitch, what else did you think?
But she has
saved... You've been with him for how long? This, how many times has he done this to you?
Yeah, and she has saved face up until this point and remained, like, the classy, composed one. But then, bitch, you're talking about your damn Plan B. And then in the preview for next week, you're like, I sat on that dick. Like, what are you doing?
I sat on it whenever I want it.
Like, what are you doing? Like, keep it, like, don't put yourself down to her level. Like, keep it up here, girl. What's your Plan B?
I just couldn't with that. I can't.
Wait, what?
When she found out that, she's like, oh, yeah, you're fucking her.
Oh, my God, I know. And she, like, attacked him in the studio.
Well, how did you not know? How did...
That's what both of these girls. I'm just like, first of all, can you... I mean...
He's not coming home to you, Amina. He's not coming home to you.
First of all, Tara...
You really think he just...
No, but like, okay, but guys, come on. As a female, it really hurts my head.
It really hurts my head. And it, honestly, this is pissing me off.
As a female, you've been with someone for 13 years. He's consistently cheated on you.
Yeah.
And then you know he's sleeping with this girl, and you know he's married to her, so clearly he's fucking her. And then you're still going to have... you know what I mean? Like, I get, like, the whole, like, I want to, you know what I mean? I can't get out of this, and I still want to go back to him. And I get the whole, you know what? I'm going to still fuck him. I get both of those. I get both sides of that. But without a condom?
Yeah, that's...
Like, what are you doing? First of all, this bitch is from Germany, and I'm not saying nothing against no Germans, nothing, but I'm just saying, you don't know who this bitch is, where she's been. Like,
it's true.
Or whoever the fuck else he's sticking his dick in. I mean, he's in West Hollywood. I mean, he's in damn Greenwich Village a lot. That's the gay part town. Who knows what Peter Guns is really doing for some money?
For real, though. I mean, clearly this man is slimy as fuck. What we see is just a storyline on TV, but it's very apparent that he's a loser.
It's clear.
And it's very apparent that he has, like, the worst midlife crisis I've ever seen in my life, like an ongoing midlife crisis. Like, you know, and especially with him being on TV, you know there's some thirsty-ass bitches that want to fuck him now.
Oh, I really hope not.
Oh, are you
Of course they are!
Are you serious?
Girls?
No.
Females are girls are the definition of the thirst. The fact that he's on Love & Hip Hop, even if a bitch didn't watch the damn show. All he has to do is go into a club and say, oh, I'm on Love and Hip Hop. That's why there's a camera in my face.
Pussy.
And there's going to be some ratchet bitches throwing themselves at him. So you know he's fucking this thing one, and, thing two, thing three.
And on top of it.
Side four.
On top of it.
Left five.
Yeah.
Bottom six.
Disgusting.
He has this swagger about him in which he thinks, like, my dick is swinging. And it must be. His dick, he must be Peter piping it down. For real.
Yeah, because these bitches be going crazy over that dick.
And come Let's on. Be real. Like, these are just That's the two girls that he fucks with. Imagine the girls that he's just fucking.
No, 1,000%.
Because there are going to be nights when, you know what, he left Tara's house a little too late and he can't go to Amina's house. So he probably like, yo, Juniper. Oh, I can't think of a name.
Juniper.
I don't
know why. That's a good guy name.
Right. That's a ratchet name. I'm going to come over to your place tonight. That cool? All right. I'm going to see you a little bit. Talking about, oh, I was busy filming all day. You know what I mean? And these little ratchet girls are probably like,
oh, okay. And furthermore, let's discuss the fact that I don't even know where I was going. I lost my train of thought.
I had a good one
right up here.
Because it's too mind-boggling for me. If you ain't talking about Amina, or if you ain't talking about Tara, it's just like...
Oh, no, I remember what I was going to say. Clearly, this is a man who is very good at manipulation. Because if you notice, anytime either of them come to him with an issue, he at first might be a little bit apologetic, but then it turns to, well, fuck you, you did this, this is your fault. That is classic, abusive manipulation. So you know that he is not just fucking two bitches. There is no way.
She really was like... I'm gonna lock the door this time.
Yeah.
I'm
lock the door. I'm finally gonna do it.
Change the locks.
I'm gonna climb through the window.
And he really will. He's gonna climb through the window. She's gonna come home one night and his naked little mole ass gonna be on the couch like.
Girl, I cannot.
I would be scared. I would really actually be scared. Like, you really have a problem. You need to get out of my house. Get out! I would seriously just.
Honestly, at this point, she does have to move. I think it's just like.
At this point, she needs to just.
Let it
she
go.
Won't though. Look how easy he got her pussy last time. Yeah. He was laying on her couch like a pathetic, sorry ass little man, laying on her damn couch in the basement. And it took all of 5 seconds for her to give up the pussy.
Circles. Let me eat your pussy. Like, she was like, yeah, that's fucking hot.
No,
like,
it was revolting. It was revolting. Like, I don't care.
How about, hey, babe, let's go out for dinner. Let's go see a movie. Like, something romantic. Something like, I'm going to work hard show you. But you really sitting up here.
We really need to talk. Like, it's getting me so irritated. Like, he's so disgusting.
Like, honestly, I feel like it's at the point where he could go to Tara and be like, well... I don't have gonorrhea. And she's like, you know what? He's really trying. He's really trying. Like,
for real.
You don't have gonorrhea. Like, that must mean something.
Peter. I'm so proud of you.
Peter. You said you were trying, Peter. I mean, what other lies are you telling us? Peter.
You don't care about your family, Peter.
Oh!
Girl, bye.
I mean, what have you been telling Amina, Peter? What else?
Her plan B needs to be to get the fuck out of this marriage. That's what her plan B needs to be. Girl, you need to activate plan B. C, I don't care, but you need to move.
I get it sometimes.
Plan A, what's this plan right now?
Bitch, what her plan needs to be is, you know what I mean? If the dick is that magnetized, then sew your damn pussy up at this point. Get a chastity belt, get something.
For real.
This ain't working for you because you going to get pregnant.
She needs to get an IUD. Or something. You need some permanent repel against his sperm. Please do not have any more children with this man. Mm. I feel like, I don't know why, I just feel like she's going to wind up pregnant at some point. I just feel it in my bones. I feel like she's going to get pregnant and that's going to be the whole next storyline is now she's pregnant. I can see it happening. I can envision it happening.
Continue this little like...
I hope they don't come back next season.
Thing, or do you think it's going to be like a Mimi thing where you see her with a new man?
I hope not. Because I
hope it's just done.
Because Mimi and her new man, that was the worst thing I've ever seen.
With her new gay boyfriend.
Her gay boyfriend. Best friend. Yeah, I cannot. That was too much. And like, I love really Mimi, but that was with Nico. Was way too much for me. Like, that was a no-no. So let's hope.
His name should have been Nicolette, not Nico. That's really my name.
Wait, so you guys just are over Tara, period?
Oh, yeah.
Completely. Honestly, next season, no more Peter and Tara.
No.
I'm with that only because I've said this multiple times.
Ruining a family.
Mona Scott, you are the devil. You are literally the devil. You have put these people on blast to make money, and I guarantee you are making tons of it because I watch this shit every week.
I'm Mona Scott. Dollar bills just raining on me. Peter Guns who? Tara who?
Yeah, ruining families.
And you know what? I said
but it, they sign up for this shit. That's true. In all fairness.
That's true. But there's a certain level of like, okay, we're not going to touch
certain things. Of not giving
things.
A fuck.
Because
yeah.
honestly, these
like,
kids are going to grow up.
She's taken Ratchet to a whole nother.
Yeah, but like, think of all 12, 13 of Peter's kids. Like, these kids are really going to grow up, go to high school. Some of them are in high school. Who knows, college, probably damn graduate in college. And they have people watching one of the number one shows on television talking about, that's your dad?
No, for real. And, like, the whole autism storyline with Saigon and Erica Jean's child, that's just shit you don't put on TV. And especially you don't show you guys getting into a physical altercation at the damn restaurant over your son having autism. You two can't hold it together for your kid for, like, one fucking hour?
I wonder if, actually, to bounce to the Saigon thing, I wonder if when they got tested, the son tested, they found out that he does have autism, that he is autistic.
And that's when they
And that's why
off.
They were like, all right, you know what, we're not going to talk about, we'll change it to more, like,
our problem.
We need to switch. Because that was weird that they didn't even mention
like, their
anything.
Son is really going to go back to this and be like, damn.
For real?
My dad's really
like...
That's what you really felt about me now? Like,
<What? laughs>
no.
Clearly we know who the favorite child is.
Right.
This bitch over here fucking doing...
But it just shows the difference between a show like Love and Hip Hop, that like you were saying with Mona Scott having like no respect for the families, because then you look at, I don't know if either you watch Real Houses in New Jersey, but then Jacqueline's son is autistic, and they just show like how hard it is for her and her family, and how much of an effort they're putting in. They show just like all the progress he's making, and they really are really sensitive to the subject. And then you have it over here on fucking Love and Hip Hop, and they're throwing each other's purses in the damn parking lot, getting in physical fights, dragging each other out
you
the motherfucking
really
car.
Threw. Her Louis across.
That would have been it for me.
Like,
I would have been like, bye.
Like...
No. That would have been it for me. I would have been like, you know what? Like, that is
You're
just...
never going to see your child again. I'm going to bash in all your car damn car windows, bash in your house, whoever damn house
no,
that you,
you
had
know
the
what?
Pool party
Honestly,
at.
Honestly, what I would have done, he threw my Louis. All right. That's just going to stay there. I'm going to leave.
For real, I would have just
I'll
left.
I'll get in the car, back up, and just never speak to this person again, and never even...
My whole thing is... My whole thing is...
Sorry, and bye. Left the Louis and him on the floor.
This man wasn't in your son's life, right? And supposedly, you were fine. You were good. You were fine raising a kid. But now you're begging this motherfucker.
You know, Saigon wants to get back into my life.
No, you're like, begging this motherfucker to be back in your life because he's the one who's hesitant about it, being like, oh, I don't know if I want to do this. And then he does a stunt like that, and you're still going to want him back in your son's life? Bitch, what the fuck are you doing?
Well, that and then... Like I just keep saying, like where these girls accept the things that they accept.
Yes.
It's like there are men out there that will treat you good. There are men. This is not the end. Just because you have a child with that man.
But
like,
this is what they want. That's the whole thing. Because if you notice, like, for example, with Mimi last on Atlanta season, she broke up with Stevie J, and then she starts saying Nico, which Nico's questionably gay, but he was a fucking clown too. Mm-hmm. It's like they are all attracted to this one type of man, so they feel like, well, if I break up with him, I'm just going to date another fucking loser, so I may as well stay with this one because I have kids with him.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? That's the mentality that these women have.
It's like, okay, you know what? How the whole gay, it gets better. Well, we need to move that to women now. Mm. Bitch, it gets better.
For real. Like,
there is better dick out there. There are better men out there. There are better fathers out there than what we are watching on this television
show. For real.
Peter Guns, I mean...
I can't.
Literally. I mean, he literally, at this point...
Rich dollars.
First of all, hold up. Last season when we saw Peter Guns, and even at the beginning of this season of Peter Guns, I was like, you know what, for a 44-year-old man, semi-attractive. But now, listen, that we've gotten to this point, he looks stressed. This man literally looks like the damn thing from Lord of the Rings.
He looks like the Crypt Keeper. He looks like he's dying.
Like, hey, kids, welcome to the Crypt!
Whatever the damn show is.
Yeah, Tales from the Crypt.
Yes.
For real, he looks terrible. He looks like shit. And it's like, well, maybe you shouldn't be biting off more than you can chew and fucking marrying this bitch and having your baby mama. And then he's complaining about, oh, I'm getting nagged from all angles. Well, then don't set yourself up in this damn situation.
What do you want? What do you
expect? That's never happening. I'm never sitting down with both of them. Yeah, because they're going to read you for filth.
For real.
For filth. It's going to be a shit show. That's exactly why you don't want to do it. And on that note, I cannot wait till next week.
And let's go into predictions. I can't wait.
You're after Buzz TV predictions.
We get Erica and Rich. Erica's excited that Rich wants to work with her. They end up making out. This is setting up Cyn finding out that they make out, because Cyn says, are you going to work with Rich? Well, if I find that there are any lines crossed, mm-hmm. I'm going to come in there.
Cyn's probably so excited. Oh, thank God. I don't got to fake this anymore. I'm so
for
done.
For real.
Just go home and eat mushroom pulley by myself. My
exactly. Her cousin is like, thank God I don't have to make out with my cousin anymore.
And then we're going to get Amina and Tara sit down with Peter, and Tara releases her ratchetness. I sat on it whenever I wanted.
Oh my God.
Congratulations, Bo. You got the dirty dick.
For real.
And Amina's crying.
She's like,
How is
Peter,
that?
You're not going to have me anymore.
How was that a shocker for her, though? Like, he basically.
Exactly.
He basically said at the club when they met up with Yandy and Kay Michelle and whoever the fuck else was there. When they met up with him, he basically sat there and said, like, I'm fucking with both of them, and maybe one day we'll sit down, a.k.a. next week when they make me sit down with both of them. Like, bitch, he's telling you pretty much in front of your face that he's fucking her. He's not coming home to you. You know he's staying at her damn house. He's saying that he still loves her in front of your face. And then she tells you that he's
fucking
them. And
I'm not going to wear the ring in
front
of
her. And it is like the fucking sky is falling and the world is over. What are you surprised? At least don't be surprised.
Like real. It's just like in your face. Like,
Jesus.
Yeah, bitch, someone could put a gun to her face and tell her to close her eyes. I'm going to kiss you and she would believe it.
For real.
About, okay,
what is wrong with her? What is wrong with her?
We'll see.
I've said this. I honestly, I really think she's a little slow.
No, I do too. I really think she has to be.
Like her and Erica Jean ride the same bus together.
The short one.
Yeah, her, Erica Jean, Lexi, Joe Budden, Peter. They go to school together.
Wait, which one's Lexi?
Tahiri's sister.
Thank God Joe Budden was not in this episode, because he is a clown.
I can't. Well, actually, I mean, he looks good versus Peter
he
Guns.
He is fucking really sexy does. Until he opens his mouth.
Well, and Peter Guns has made Stevie J. Stevie J is just probably the happiest man in the
honestly,
world.
Honestly, Stevie J, I don't even mind it.
At this point,
I don't either, because he's funny. He's at least entertaining to watch. Peter is irritating as fuck. Stevie J was at least entertaining.
And Stevie J, honestly, Stevie J would never speak to those women the way that Peter's
no.
Oh, yeah, no. Stevie J just really be, like, telling them what it is.
Yeah, he's like, baby.
Baby, you know I'm going to go fuck her. Like,
yeah.
You
what
late?
You want me
do
to
you
say?
And Jasmine's like, you know he always going to come home to me. So, and he was just like, oh, okay. Yeah, you're right. Let me just get my gay boyfriend.
My boyfriend's obsessed with Stevie J. He's like, Stevie J, I love Stevie J. I'm like, yeah.
And Peter
relax.
Just looks like
trash.
Oh, yeah,
let's not
like,
give him all
Peter's like, you tried it. Stevie J's like, Peter, you tried it. Shit show.
I can't.
On that note, I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you guys hit us up at iTunes. Subscribe to our podcast, Love and Hip Hop. I was going to say Atlanta because we're talking about Stephen J so much. Love and Hip Hop, AfterBuzz TV. Subscribe, rate, leave us a comment. Show us love. It helps keep the lights on here at AfterBuzz TV. Gets us to number one. Also, tweet us at AfterBuzz TV. Tweet me at DJ Jesse J.
Me at Sensei DR. I mean, just kidding, Sensei don't play.
And me at Julie Ofcharsky.
Until next week, same time, same place, more ratchetness. Peace.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Yeah, later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.
Thank you for watching AfterBuzz TV on YouTube. For more of your favorite after shows and interviews, subscribe to our channel here, and be sure to share your opinion on the episode in the comment section below here. We'd love to see what you guys are buzzing about. Thanks again. Buzz you later.